Hey, what's up? Yo, Jasper.
Hey, what's up?
What's up?
Welcome to the Transcript.
This week, the Transcript looks into modern paganism,
drops eggs with Mr. Heaney,
and takes a stab into NHS's fencing team.
Stay tuned to the end of the episode for more information about function lust.
On Wednesday, Chloe Swarbrick, a 25-year-old New Zealand legislator, delivered a speech in support of the Zero Carbon Bill, which hopes to lower the island nation's greenhouse emissions and establish a new climate change commission. During her speech, Swarbrick came under fire from an older member of Parliament and shot back with, quote, "Okay, boomer," unquote. On Tuesday, denizens of Northampton voted in this year's local elections. Members were voted in for the school committee, city council, and other municipal positions. The Northampton Gazette reports that this year will bring a makeover to the Northampton political scene, with many newcomers to the political landscape taking positions across the city. Next week, the House Intelligence Committee plans to hold its first public impeachment hearings. Former top Ukraine diplomat William Taylor and current Europe advisor George Kent will testify Wednesday, and ex-US ambassador to Ukraine Marie Yovanovitch will testify Friday. A transcript of Yovanovitch's earlier testimony was released Monday, and Taylor's transcript is set to be released Wednesday. The Department of Justice on Wednesday charged two former Twitter employees with espionage against the United States, accusing the men of accessing information on Saudi dissidents who used the social networking site. Allegedly, in 2015, the two men accessed the information of more than 6,000 Twitter users, including prominent anti-government dissidents. This is the first time federal prosecutors have ever charged Saudis with espionage inside the United States.
Hi, welcome to Smarts and Crafts. This week, we're sitting down with
Matt Heaney.
Today, we're making an egg drop competition.
So, Mr. Heaney, can you tell us what you do here at the high school?
I'm a teacher in the science department here at the high school. This semester, I'm teaching all physics. Next semester will be all earth and space science. So the basic idea is we're going to drop an egg from a set height, and we want the egg to not crack.
That is correct.
Okay, so we want to minimize the force on our eggs.
So what do you like to do outside of school?
So outside of school, I have two relatively young children, a three-year-old and a five-year-old. So that takes up a good chunk of my time. When I do have time outside of work and parenting, I like to be outside. I like to swim. I like to ride my bike, and I run because I like to eat, and I want to continue to, you know, make it to 40 and beyond. I like to read when I'm awake at the end of the day. That pretty much takes up most of my time.
Have you always been a swimmer?
I was a swimmer starting pretty early on. I swam in high school. I was one of only two people in my high school who was both on the swim team and on the football team. I was actually a college professor for a couple of years. I'll just toss these in here for for extra ballast. I did something called the Brooklyn Bridge Swim, where you swim from Brooklyn to Manhattan underneath the Brooklyn Bridge. And the East River is not a pristine body of water. It's probably the second grossest body of water I've ever gone swimming in.
I wish I made my strings equal length. All right, let's go drop these.
Let's do it.
Did yours look like it's safe?
I think mine's safe.
I had you
weavers, 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 we are weaving the web of life. Weavers, 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 we are weaving the web of life. Weavers.
The best way to understand paganism, I think, is if you think of the indigenous peoples of this land. They were very community-based, and they depended very much upon each other. The earth gives us life, and the earth has a life of her own. We are not separate from nature.
My family is atheist, but we celebrate some pagan holidays. My favorite pagan holiday is May Day. Probably because it's like celebrating the beginning of spring and the saying goodbye to winter. I feel like pagan holidays and just paganism is more connected to nature and like being aware of the world around us, whereas often mainstream culture focuses more on the self.
Weavers, 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 we are weaving the web of life. Weavers, 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 we are weaving the web of life. Weavers, weavers, we are weaving the web of life. Weavers, 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 we are weaving the
Hamped Up.
Y'all ready for this?
As the fall sports season comes to an end and students prepare to put away their helmets and cleats for the season, it may surprise you that others are readying to draw their weapons in the spirit of competition. With a rich history tracing back to the 12th century, fencing combines coordination and technique in a unique and competitive manner. This week, we sat down with fencing coach Nicole Mann and NHS fencer Krista Jordan to ask them about the high school fencing experience.
So as a fencing club, it means that we don't have the access to the money and the facilities that would be supported with the Northampton High School team. We have the same sort of environment as a team sport. It's just what we're doing is much more focused on individual participation, as opposed to we're all going to go to the stands and have cheerleaders and do all the fun things that most team sports actually get. The way that the Northampton High School works for their fencing club is they come to PVFA for the facility. So PVFA, Pioneer Valley Fencing Academy, I remember, donates the space to the fencing students, because beforehand they were utilizing the cafeteria space, which means a lot of time is spent sweeping and moving tables and setting up the equipment that we have here in the space.
It's definitely hard to not be recognized as a team, because we do put in a lot of work and effort. We do a lot of conditioning, a lot of stuff that like actual sports teams at NHS do, but we don't get recognized for that. A lot of people don't even know there is a fencing like club.
So the club dues that come in from that are, I believe it's about $200. Depending on if you're volunteering your time as an armorer, so you're fixing all of the fancy weapons, whatever you're doing, you're recruiting people, you're bringing people in. Every person that comes in brings more funds to the school, or from the school, and brings more funds in to have the equipment here.
So the fencing team is a great balance between an actual sport that's rigorous and it's going to get you into great shape and improve your reflexes, but it's also a really good atmosphere. Like I said before, we're like kind of a family here, because we're a smaller team. We're under 20 people. We all know each other. We know inside jokes and we do fun things together. We go out and play laser tag and stuff, and so it's really a lot of fun.
I'm Nika Mastrangelo, and welcome to Nacho Average Interview Show. Today, thanks to the Brewhouse Nachos from the brewery, we got two special guests, Sebastian Abend, leader of Leaders Club, and Austin Perret, the man, the myth, the legend. The house is burning. It's burning down. It's ablaze.
Who's in it?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know. I just know the house is on fire.
Come see the improv troupe perform tonight at 6:20 at Click Workspace in downtown Northampton.
Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to watch this week's online extra politicked off on www.devilsadvocate.news.